The Battle of Chawinda was a major engagement between Pakistan and India in the Second Kashmir War as part of the Sialkot campaign. It is well known as being one of the largest tank battles in history since the Battle of Kursk, which was fought between the Soviet Union and Nazi Germany in World War II. The initial clashes in Chawinda coincided with the Battle of Phillora, and the fighting here intensified once the Pakistani forces at Phillora retreated. The battle came to an end shortly before the United Nations Security Council mandated an immediate ceasefire, which would formally end the hostilities of the 1965 war. Chapter 1, Sialkot Campaign. The Sialkot Campaign was part of the strategy of riposte that India had devised to counter Pakistan's advances into Jammu and Kashmir. It called for relieving Jammu by advancing from either Sambo or Dera Baba Nanak with a view to encircling the city of Sialkot along the Marala-Ravi Link Canal. The canal starts from the Marala headworks on the Chenab River close to Pakistan's border with J&K, and runs to the west and south of Sialkot, eventually draining into the Ravi River near the town of Narang Mandi. The Gorkh Western Command General Harbaksh Singh favoured launching the campaign from Dera Baba Nanak using the 1st Armoured Division. But he was overridden by the Chief of Army Staff General J.N. Chowdhury, who created a new I Corps under the command of Lieutenant General Pat Dunn for the purpose. It would operate from Sambo. General Dunn was given an assortment of units. In addition to the 1st Armoured Division under Major General Rajinder Singh, he had the 6th Mountain Division under Major General S.K. Kaula, the 14th Infantry Division under Major General Ranjit Singh, and the 26th Infantry Division under Major General M.L. Thapan. The new corps was still in the process of formation when the hostilities broke out in September 1965. Some of the units were also under strength because of their forces being tied up elsewhere. According to the Indian official history, the force contained 11 infantry brigades and 6 tank regiments. Chapter 1, Section 1, Pakistani Defense. The Pakistani forces opposing the Indian thrust were part of Pakistan's I Corps under Lieutenant General Bakhtiar Rana. Included in it were the 6th Armored Division commanded by Major General Abrar Hussain, the 4th Artillery Corps under Brig Amjad Ali Khan Chowdhury, and the 15th Infantry Division under Brig S. M. Ismail. The 15th Infantry Division was a mixed infantry and armor force, with 4 pairs of a brigade and an armored regiment each. However, only 1 out of the 4 pairs was in the conflict area when the Indian campaign started. They were based in and around Chawinda. The 24th Brigade was commanded by Brig Abdul Ali Malik, and the 25th Cavalry was led by Lieutenant Colonel Nisar Ahmed Khan. The 6th Armored Division, normally based at Gujranwala, was moved to Pasra in preparation for the war. It had 3 cavalry regiments, 10th Cavalry, the 22nd Cavalry, and the 11th Cavalry. The 11th Cavalry, along with the 4th Artillery Corps, was in Chamber as part of Operation Grand Slam when the operations started. The units were recalled and deployed in the vicinity of Phillora by the 8th of September. Later reinforcements included the 8th Infantry Division and 1st Armored Division. Chapter 2, The Battle. The main striking force of the Indian I Corps was the 1st Armored Division, which was supported by the 14th Infantry and 6th Mountain Divisions. Indian forces seized the border area on the 7th of September 1965. This was followed by a short engagement at Jasaran in which the Pakistanis suffered losses in the form of about 10 tanks, consequently ensuring complete Indian dominance over the Sialkot-Pasra Railway. Realizing the severe threat posed by the Indians in Sialkot, the Pakistanis rushed 2 regiments of the 6th Armored Division from Chamb, Indian-administered Jammu and Kashmir, to the Sialkot sector to support the Pakistani 7th Infantry Division fighting there. These units, supported by an independent tank destroyer squadron, amounted to about 135 tanks, 24 M47 and M48 Pattons, about 15 M36 B1s and the rest Shermans. The majority of the American pattens belonged to the new 25th Cavalry under the command of Lieutenant Colonel Nisar Ahmed Khan, which was sent to Chawinda. Intense fighting around the village of Gajor, between the Indian 1st Armored Division and the Pakistani 25th Cavalry Regiment, resulted in the Indian advance being stopped. The Indian plan was to drive a wedge between Sialkot and the Pakistani 6th Armored Division. At the time, only one Pakistani regiment was present in the area, and it was wiped out by the Indian 1st Armored Division's thrust, spearheaded by the 43rd Lorried Infantry Brigade and a tank regiment attacking Ghat. The bulk of the Indian 1st Armored Brigade was hurled towards Phillora. Pakistani air attacks caused significant damage to the Indian tank columns and exacted a heavy toll on the truck columns and infantry. The terrain of the area was very different from that of the area surrounding Lahore, being quite dusty, and therefore the Indian offensive's advance was evident to the Pakistani 25th Cavalry by the rising dust columns on the Chawinda-Phillora Road. Indian forces resumed their offensive on 10 September 1965 with multiple corps-sized assaults and succeeded in pushing the Pakistani forces back to their base at Chawinda, where the Indian advance was eventually stopped. A Pakistani counter-attack at Phillora was repulsed with heavy losses, after which the Pakistanis took up defensive positions. The situation for the Pakistanis at this point was highly perilous. The Indians outnumbered them 10-1. However, the Pakistani situation improved as reinforcements arrived, consisting of two independent brigades from Kashmir, the 8th Infantry Division, and more crucially, the 1st Armored Division. For the next several days, Pakistani forces repulsed Indian attacks on Chawinda. A major Indian assault involving India's 1st Armoured and 6th Mountain Divisions on 18 September was repelled, with the Indians suffering heavy losses. Following this, on 21 September, the Indians withdrew to a defensive position near their original bridgehead. With the retreat of India's advancing divisions, all the offensives were effectively halted on that front. Pakistani officers vetoed the proposed counterattack, dubbed Operation Wind-Up, in light of the Indians' retreat. According to the Pakistani commander-in-chief, the operation was cancelled due to the fact that both sides had suffered heavy tank losses. Would have been of no strategic importance. And, above all, the decision was politically motivated, as by then the government of Pakistan had made up their mind to accept ceasefire and foreign-sponsored proposals. Chapter 3, Outcome. The battle has widely been described as one of the largest tank battles since World War II. On 22 September 1965, the United Nations Security Council unanimously passed a resolution that called for an immediate and unconditional ceasefire from both nations. The war ended the following day. The international military and economic assistance to both countries had stopped when the war started. Pakistan had suffered attrition to its military might and serious reverses in the Battle of Sialkot and Chawinda, which made way for its acceptance of the United Nations ceasefire. Following the end of hostilities on 23 September 1965, India claimed to have held about 518 square kilometers of Pakistani territory in the Sialkot sector of territory, including the towns and villages of Phillora, Doli, Bajragri, Sushegra Pagawal, Chapra, Mahadpur, and Tilakpur. These were all returned to Pakistan after the signing of the Tashkent Declaration in January 1966. Chapter 4, Published Accounts. Chapter 4, Section 1, Documentaries. Battle of Chawinda minus Indo-Pak War 1965 minus Lieutenant Colonel Ardisha Tarapore is an Indian TV documentary which premiered on Veer by Discovery India.